pigs are a major issue for us. Our family's seen the pig population rise and fall over the years. I reckon we have an obligation to control the pigs for their predation on wildlife, bird breeding colonies, frogs, lizards, all the native. But the impact on my business, which I suppose was your question, was sort of more like, they damage the landscape, root up my pastures, damage my fences. In a roundabout way, I've a problem with illegal hunting. So if I've got a low pig population, I don't have as much grief with illegal hunting. And then, of course, we've got the disease risk with disease and cross infection to my animal production system, which in my case would be cattle. So the latest research is that we have a high percentage of leptospirosis in the pig population here. So that to me means another booster, an extra booster, which isn't a big cost, but the inconvenience of having to put 800 breeding cows through the yard and vaccinate them again, and I suppose the stress on the livestock. So yeah, the disease issue, and we live in fear of what would happen if we had a foot and mouth disease outbreak. So the disease side of it is probably the most important factor of all. Spend a lot of time managing our pigs. In the early 80s, there was a very, very effective poisoning program went through, and then aerial shooting started in the early 90s. And up to date, aerial shooting's been the main method, but I personally continue with poisoning. I think it's a good combination to work with aerial shooting, and as well as trapping. At times I do a fair bit of trapping.
Well, they can have a huge effect on the land. Lose a lot of lambs to the pigs when they get into it. Some pigs aren't into it, but once they get to know, they're very bad. Oh, 30-40%,
yeah.
You could lose if you didn't do any baiting. But my wife's place once when it was flooding, they poisoned one side of the flood and not the other side, and it was 30-40% difference in the lambing. Yeah, definitely when it's hot and dry and they're all in around the dams. When it rains and there's a water scattered and lush feed, they go off digging up worms and such, and they're harder to poison.
This year's lambing has turned out to be another disaster due to pig devastation. In as much as we put 3,492 ewes out to lamb in the middle of March, scanned in lamb, and only marked 1,102 lambs. I believe conclusively that most of our losses were due to pigs, a tremendous outbreak of pigs following the third recently wet summer and following a very wet December-January. Well, we're cooperating with the government agencies, two CMAs, bordering on this area, number one. I think most landholders here have set up trapping situations on their own properties. I know I certainly have. I'm letting one of the men who works here with me take some of the time each week to devote solely to trapping pigs, destroying the younger ones and selling the heavier ones.
In the ideal world, we'd all be moving forward. Like every other thing that a progressive landholder does, he's hopefully moving forward with his land management. And if we're not with our pig control, something's wrong.